Oh my gosh, she got on hot waters.
I like me better when I was yours. I'm going back, I'm going back, I'm going back, I'm going back, I'm going back to who I was before. I like me better, I like me better, yeah, yeah, yeah.
What's good? What's poppin', Golden Bays? Welcome back to another week in my life. So today is actually Monday, September 27th, and as you guys see, I'm at the gas station filling up. And it's actually finished, y'all. My car took the whole $50. But yeah, I'm at the gas station filling up. I'm actually about to meet Kelsey at Panera Bread. We were supposed to go to the library, but the library by my house is pretty small, so the seats are always taken up pretty quickly. And then, of course, with COVID, they still have, you know, like every other seat, you know, blocked off. So that takes up more seats. So there's even less than what it normally would be. But that always happens. There's, you know, always no room at the library near my house. If it is, y'all, it's a good day. So we just meet at Panera Bread. But I have to fill up first, as you guys see, because your girl was on E. I literally wait until the last minute to get gas, and it's horrible. It is bad, y'all. I just do not like coming to the gas station. But yeah, let me go ahead and get this pump out my car so I can go ahead and head to Panera Bread. I'll talk to you guys once we get there. We're gonna study. We do have class at 1:30. So yeah, I'll talk to you guys once I get to Panera Bread. Do not mind my back seat looking a hot mess. I have to take this package to, I think it's FedEx, and then I have a huge garbage bag in my back seat full of clothes that need to be altered. So that's another thing that we're gonna do today. Once I leave Panera Bread, which is gonna be after class, we get out of class at like 4 o'clock, sometimes earlier if, you know, we finish the lesson. I'm going to head to a tailor that I found before I go to the gym and get all sweaty and stuff. I'm gonna go there after Panera Bread, and then yeah, so I'm not gonna take that whole trash bag in there first. I have 3 items that I decided to take in there because I want to, you know, try them out. This is my first time going to them. I want to see their pricing and stuff like that. So I have 2 pairs of shorts and 1 pair of jeans. I feel like that's super easy to tailor, you know, and then from there I'll see if I like them. If I like them, then girl, they will get the whole trash bag, because that is why I have so many clothes, but y'all, none of them fit. I have like a huge gap in the back. They don't fit. So we need to take care of that today. I need to get this package out. But yeah, we actually just got an order. Okay, it's a concept map, so it's not something that I have to package up. But yeah, you guys, last night was the virtual girls night. I had so much fun. If you attended the virtual girls night, I hope you had as much fun as I did. I know you guys did, because y'all literally told me, like, we always have fun. And like I said, we was on there for 4 hours. It started at 6, and then we got off at 10 o'clock on the dot. Like, we always have a ball. The winners got picked, so I actually got to handle that today as well. I did have 4 winners that was not on the virtual girls night, so I'm going to reach out to them today. Also today, you guys, I need to order a, like, something for my camera, because I still have no type of holder for my camera. I actually heard that Velcro is best. A lot of people buy Velcro from like Amazon, and then they stick it on their dash, and then they stick the other half on the camera. And I heard that actually works very well. A lot of people also use Velcro for pictures, like when they hang pictures in their house. So we'll see. I'm gonna order it today once I like sit down and get settled. But yeah, let me get to Panera Bread, because I really cannot drive with this camera up here. It will fall, and y'all know I just bought this camera, so we cannot break it. All right. So I'll see y'all once I meet up with Kelsey.
Don't you worry, don't be scared, I'll be there in a hurry. Keep it hot, but the drip on McFlurry. No second guessing this section for surely. Run it up, uncontested like free throws. I'm all in every time like casinos. Came here strictly for chips, I don't mingle. I just cash in, that my fashion. Run it up, uncontested like free throws. I'm all in every time like casinos. Came here strictly for chips, I don't mingle. I just cash in, that my fashion. Time and time again,
They gon' show how they hate to see you win. Level up, it won't be the same again. It's a whole lot of ways of living. Life's a livid, I'm indifferent. Apologies if I seem uninterested, but I don't care about your opinions. It'd be better if you pay attention, pay attention.
What is up, you guys? So as you guys can probably tell, it is a lot later in the day. I am home now. As you guys can tell, I got a candle lit. It is a lot later. It is actually going on 9 o'clock. I just got in the house from the gym. I had a super bomb workout. As you guys know, I do have a trainer. And on Mondays, we do something called AMRAP Mondays. So AMRAP stands for as many rounds as possible. And I am actually going on my second month with my trainer. So today I was like, you know what, for AMRAP Monday, I want to hit 4 rounds, because what our trainer does is she gives us workouts and it's as many rounds as you can do. And at first I was hitting 4, so I was like, you know what, if I can get above 4, I'll be super happy. So today I actually hit 5.5. So I was, your girl walked out the gym like, excuse me, 5.5, yes ma'am. So that just means, of course, my endurance is going up, and that's what's great about going to the gym, because not all the time it's about, you know, seeing numbers drop. Of course, when you hop on a scale and you see that you lost, you know, 5-10 pounds, it's great. And I have actually lost 13 pounds. I am losing weight, don't get me wrong, but that's not what I'm only going to the gym for. I'm going to the gym because I want to increase my endurance. I want to be able to run longer. I want to be able, you know, to lift heavier weights. And I am seeing improvement, and not just in the scale, because like I said, I am losing weight. The pounds are dropping off. However, I am definitely noticing that your girl is able to run now at 6 miles per hour. Who? Me. Me. I'm able to do push-ups. I'm able to actually work out with heavier weights, because when I first started with my trainer, for leg days, I would grab 10 pounds. Now I'm up to 20 and 25 because I'm actually building muscles, you know, in my legs. So it's great. That's my little rant for exercising. Like I said, it is nice to hop on the scale and see pounds fall off. Like I said, I did lose like 13 pounds because I was 148 pounds and now I'm down to 135. So it's great to see, you know, pounds come off, but it's not all about that all the time. You want to increase your endurance. Like I said, I'm able to run now like for a longer period of time at a faster speed. I wasn't able to do that before. I'm able to lift heavier weights. Definitely wasn't able to do that before. So it's all about challenging yourself. And then apart from actually being in the gym, it's also about growing your mental state about going to the gym. You cannot look at the gym as, oh, I gotta go to the gym. I'm actually very excited to go to the gym. Major reason, because your girl is a nursing student. Like, I'm stressed. So when I go to the gym, they say the gym, of course, releases happy hormones, and it really does. When I leave the gym, you guys, I feel so like relaxed because I don't focus on school at the gym. I literally have my music so loud and it helps you, like, you know. So I keep saying that's my little rant about the gym. I just wanted to go ahead and throw that out there. But as far as my gym outfit for today, I'll have it linked in the description box down below. And make sure you guys are always checking my description box, because I really try to, well, I'm starting to try to include things that I think you guys would ask me for. So that, like, you know, kind of beats you to commenting and you like having to wait for my response. And then of course you guys can always DM me if I don't, or, you know, of course comment. But I'm starting to try to include things that I think you guys would ask me for, like, for instance, if I have on a shirt or I have on, you know, like an outfit. So I'll have this gym outfit listed in the description box down below. These leggings, you guys, are actually new. I just got them last week and they're chef's kiss. Okay, like, for the price, girl, they're amazing. So definitely check out my links for this gym outfit. It's just this black, you know, set that I have on. It's not a set. I did buy them separate, but the sports bra does have like this zipper detailing. Super cute. If you're like me, I like to wear black to the gym. One, because you cannot see me sweat, especially if I choose to wear my sweat belt. I also have that listed down below. If I choose to wear my sweat belt, I don't want to have on tan, and girl, you will see the sweat like in your crotch area. And then of course you're at the gym, so nobody's gonna be like, oh my god, you know, because like obviously it's sweat, but you know, just we can kind of move around that by just wearing black. And of course black just, it just looks good. Okay, so yeah, I'll have the sports bra, the new pants, like I said, that I got, super amazing, you guys, for the price. The quality is, girl, and the band on these leggings, they do not drop. When I do my run on the treadmill, like I said, at 6 miles per hour, they do not fold. They do not budge or anything. So that's one thing that I really like about these. As far as the length, I am 5'2", so I am not super tall. So for my taller people, these do stop exactly at my ankle. So you may have like a little challenge when it comes to the ankle part. But again, you're at the gym, so it's not like, oh my gosh, she got on hot waters. You know, it's not like that. So check it out, sports bra, the leggings, and then I also have my sweat belt, and also I'll list my gloves, because like I said, I do weight train, so I like to wear weightlifting gloves, because you guys know you'll start to get the calluses on your hands, and I actually have one right here. So yeah, I'm back into wearing my gloves. I don't know why I forgot that I had some, and I'm back to wearing them. So this is actually going down, thank God, because girl, that is not cute, okay? While we are on the topic about, you know, going to the gym and being fit, you know, and, you know, just trying to improve our quality of life, I just wanted to go ahead and shout out today's Golden Girl sponsor. So today's video is actually sponsored by a poll of you guys, and I wanted to give a huge shout out to them for sponsoring today's video. And I'm actually really excited to show you guys what exactly this is, because like I said, while we're on the topic of going to the gym and, you know, getting better in the gym and improving yourself and lifting heavier weights and, you know, having a higher endurance and all that good stuff, a Pove comes right into play with this, all right? They actually sent me over a massage gun. And like I said, you guys, when I first started in the gym, I was only lifting 10-pound weights when we would have leg day. I'm up to 20-25. Well, today I actually did 20-25, and your girl was gonna be sore, okay? I already feel it in my booty. I felt it when I was leaving the gym. Before we get into the details of the massage gun, I just wanted to talk to you guys why this would be beneficial. Of course, when you go to the gym, you leave sore. But why? Because you have that buildup of lactic acid. And aside from stretching before and after your workouts, and of course increasing your fluids to, you know, get your muscles back hydrated and move that lactic out, you can use a massage gun. And when I tell you guys, this thing amazing, and I don't know why I did not have one before. Now getting into the massage gun, again, shout out to them for sending this, because ever since I got this, you guys, I use it. And it's not just for going to the gym. Of course it's great for athletes, but if you're in the medical field, I am on my feet for 12.5 hours. I am turning patients that are, we can say, like twice my size, like, you know. So this is amazing when you come home from work. I also like to use this when I come home from work. I love to use it on my feet, girl. But also when you have like your boyfriend or your girlfriend home with you, you can ask them to massage your back. Lay on your stomach, have them massage your back. So when I tell y'all, me and my boyfriend love this, like, he asked me, can he hold it? No, you cannot hold my massage gun. This is staying here. This is what the massage gun looks like, you guys. Super nice. And when I tell you, this would make a very nice Christmas gift. You guys know that Christmas is coming up. If you have someone that you know is like in the gym, amazing. A healthcare worker, a nurse, LPN, CNA. This is amazing. Like I said, you guys, when I get home from work, I literally just, I put a pair of socks on. Sometimes I'll have like a towel or something in between, so the pressure isn't too hard, and I'll just sit there and massage my feet. I'll do like a minute and a half on, and then I'll let my feet rest, and then I'll do it again. Tonight I'm mainly going to be focusing on my thighs, because I felt it when I left the gym. Even after my stretch, I'm going to be hitting my thighs tonight, and then like also my lower back. I'm going to do as much as I can by myself, but when I see my boyfriend tomorrow, I'm going to be like, can you please get me right with the gun, please? This is what it looks like. Super nice. It's very nice and sleek. I definitely noticed that when I took it out of the box. Very nice and sleek. And as you guys can see, it does have you guys can't see anything because I don't have it on. Here is the on button down here. Also, this is where you charge it. But when you turn it on, you guys will see that it does have a like LED display. So it's super nice. Like, you know, it just gives you that very... Y'all know what I'm trying to say. It just gives you that like very this expensive feeling, all right? But it does have four modes, so you can turn it on one, and I'm gonna show you guys. You can turn it on one. Yeah, girl, that's one, two, three, and four. And then when you hit it again, it's gonna turn off. Well, I hit it too fast. You see four, and then again, and then it shuts off. So, and then also you can do manual or you can do a auto setting. So that's really it, you guys. There's no like major, you know, settings when it comes to this. You have four modes, which I think is great. Also, the packaging, you guys, just the way that it comes, it looks very, very sleek. I'm sure by now, or I'll insert it now, the official unboxing of this when I first got it, but it just looks super sleek, and I think it'll make like a really nice Christmas gift because the way that it comes, it has all these different attachments, so you can change the attachment based on the body part that you want to actually massage. So this, I think, would be great for your spine. I haven't tried it yet, but now that I'm like looking at it, I think this would be great for your spine because, you know, you can actually go down your back and your spine could be in the middle because, of course, you don't want to injure yourself. So yeah, I think this would make a super nice Christmas gift. And just the way that it comes, everything from the outside box, it just looks very sleek. I feel like when someone like opens this on Christmas and like they actually unwrap it, they're gonna be like, this is nice, like, you know. So also, before I go, I just wanted to mention, you guys, that the battery life on this is amazing. I've been using it for probably like a week and a half and I haven't charged it yet, and I typically use it for about like 10 to 15 minutes. Like I said, I just massage really what's hurting, like whatever's hurting me that day. Like if it's my feet, like my feet are sore, or like my lower back, like let's say I had a lot of heavy patients, I may do my lower back, or I may do my arms if it's arm day. But you guys, this thing is amazing. So I just wanted to go ahead and shout out Apob and say thank you for sponsoring today's video, but also thank you for sending over this massage gun because it changed your girl life, okay? And also, y'all, this is available on Amazon, and you guys know how much I love Amazon. It is super easy to order from Amazon. The return policy is chef's kiss. Also, it's Prime. You guys know you can always go in there and read your reviews. You can look at other people's, you know, opinions, their pictures, their videos. So that's another plus. Y'all know I love me some Amazon Prime. Let me go ahead and take a shower, get myself all freshened up, and we're gonna go ahead and make dinner. I probably won't talk to you guys again until tomorrow, but I'll go ahead and insert some clips of me making dinner and, you know, relaxing and stuff like that. I am going to listen to some audios before I go to sleep because you guys know I do have an exam tomorrow, so I'm gonna get some last minute studying in. I was listening to an audio at the gym, but my phone died. Like, I can't even blame my phone because we had a full day today, like a long day. So I'm gonna probably listen to an audio while I'm cooking and stuff like that because it really shouldn't take long. Like, I'm making pasta and then like I'm pan searing chicken. So yeah, I'm about to take a shower, get clean, because I know I stink. And I get my hair done on Thursday, you guys. You guys can probably see my new growth. I have new growth up to here. This is all new growth. When you guys like see curliness in my hair, I have new growth. So I have an appointment for a relaxer on Thursday. I'm really excited about that. So for the rest of the week, you guys will see my bun. I can't even say slick back because the girl is not even slick no more. Okay, she just there. She is just a bun. I'm about to go ahead and get ready for bed. I will talk to you guys in the morning. But until then, enjoy these clips of me cooking dinner.
If I stayed back, What would happen if I never found you? Those times were hard and all I did was resent you. Oh no, I don't want to go back. Oh, how naive I was. I'm running to where my hope is, where I know I'm free.
So it is the next day. I believe the last time that I spoke to you guys, I was just getting home from the gym and then I made dinner and stuff like that. But I am at the table. Y'all, my brain is just farting right now. I'm at the table. It's 11:18 a.m. I actually finished an audio this morning. Right now we are doing trauma. So things like pneumothorax and blunt chest traumas and stabbings and gunshot wounds. That's what we're doing right now. So I finished an audio this morning and then I had to switch out of nursing student mode and get into influencer slash business mode. Okay. So you guys know that we had the giveaway. The winners were chosen and now I am getting the prizes out. So some people won like digital products, the concept maps. So those are pretty easy to get out because they're just emails. And then I have other people that are getting actual physical products from my business, which are the Golden Nurse Co-Packs. So I'm like in contact with people, getting emails, addresses, confirming those addresses just to make sure, you know, when I send the product out, there's no, you know, issue with delivery, incorrect address, incomplete address, things like that. And then I had the Starbucks winner. She already got her prize yesterday. That was another digital prize where I just went on starbucks.com, entered her email, and then it sent it straight to her. She got it. She loves it. Beautiful. So y'all, there is so much that goes on behind the scenes of like everything, honestly, like YouTube, my business. Like, just because I'm sending out these prizes, like I have to keep track of everything. I have to keep track of the prize, shipping labels, and then just making sure everyone is getting their items. It's going to the right address, it's going to the right email address. Things like that. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm actually about to take a break because I'm about to shift back into nursing student mode and watch some YouTube videos on pneumothorax and things like that. But first I'm gonna make some breakfast. I'm about to make a bacon, egg, and cheese bagel. I like to use turkey bacon. I really don't like regular bacon, y'all. I don't know if I ever told y'all that, but I'm not a huge fan of like regular pork bacon. I'll eat it, but if I have the choice, I'll definitely choose turkey bacon over pork bacon. Like, I prefer turkey bacon. So that's what I'm about to do, and then I'm going to get these YouTube videos done just so I can get a better understanding of sorry guys, I'm getting responses from the winner saying like, hey, I got it, thank you. So awesome. When I see those DMs, I'm like, beautiful, making sure everyone's getting their stuff. So yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, I'm about to make some breakfast and then I'm going to watch some YouTube videos to get a better understanding of all of these trauma conditions. And yeah, I am probably not gonna go to the library today. I think I'm gonna just stay home and have lecture. Usually, like I said, me and Kelsey go to the library for lecture, which is from 1:30 to 4. I might change my mind. If I do, you guys will see. But yeah, I actually have some clips from last week that I want to include in this vlog because I did like somewhat vlog last week and I don't want those clips to go to waste because I actually had a really fun time. Me and my entire nursing group, you guys, it is so hard to get all of us out at the same time. Some of them have kids and you know, like getting a babysitter and just coordinating can be a huge challenge. So we all got out at the same time and y'all, we had a blast. We went down to Clematis. We went to like 3 to 4 different like clubs and bars. It was so much fun. So while I make breakfast and watch these YouTube videos, I'm gonna go ahead and play the clips from last week because I definitely want to include them. I don't want you guys to miss out on, you know, the shenanigans. But yeah, you guys watch these clips. I'm about to go get some food in my stomach and watch these YouTube videos and I'll see you guys later. Hey you guys, so good morning. I just got to the clubhouse, as you guys saw. I got up this morning, made some coffee. I actually ate something really quick before I left the house. And now I am at the clubhouse getting ready to take my exam. I like to come to the clubhouse ever since the pandemic started, when everything first started. Everyone was home, so my mom was home, my sister was home, the libraries were closed. So the only place for me to come to was the clubhouse to take my exams. And now that everything is pretty much, of course, back open, my mom's at work, my sister's at work, the house is quiet. I could take my exam at home, you know, but I've gotten so used to coming here. I've been doing it ever since like the middle of semester two, so that's like a year and a half. I don't wanna break my habit, you know? So I'm here now, it is about like 11:20, maybe close to 11:30. My exam isn't until 1:30. So I like to give myself like an hour, hour and a half to study, and then I give myself like a nice 30 to 45 minute break. You know, before the exam starts, because I hate to study right up until the exam because your brain just feels so smothered. So definitely give yourself like a 30-45 minute break before your exam starts. That is my key. That's what works for me. So yeah, I'm here. I'm about to go ahead and get started. Later on today, you guys know that I'm supposed to be meeting up with the girls, my nursing crew, to go out and have some drinks. But let's get this exam done first. Y'all, I'm over this material, okay? Last night when I was making dinner, I was listening to audios. I was listening to Nurse Sarah here on YouTube and just Nurse Mike. So that's another tip. When you're in the shower making dinner or something like that on your way to work, I always say this, guys, listen to audios. You don't always have to study by reading something. Just listen to it. So it was funny because me and my boyfriend was doing that. He muted his phone. We were on FaceTime. He muted his phone, I muted mine, and we were listening to our audios because Bae actually has an exam this morning and I need to text him to see how it went. But I am tired of reading the same material. I'm to the point where I know what I know and I don't know what I don't know, okay? Like, it's just prayers and vibes right now. Prayers and vibes, because your girl is tired. She's tired, but yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and knock this exam out so we can go out tonight and get some drinks. But it is a pretty gloomy day today. Hopefully it clears up, because you guys know I live in Florida, so we got the palm trees and stuff, and it's just a vibe when it's sunny outside, because you know, it just looks all cute. So hopefully it clears up. If not, we still going out, because your girl still need a margarita, because it's a no for me today. It's a no. So yeah, let's go ahead and knock this out. I'll probably pick up the camera before I head out, you know, to the outing tonight, but I'm gonna try and get my batteries fully charged up. That way you guys can come out with me tonight. So if I do pick up the camera, it may be like for, you know, like, hey girl, I'm home or whatever. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get these batteries charged up, because I heard that these batteries like die pretty quickly. Honestly, it makes no difference than my Canon G7X. You guys know that I did get a new camera. I'll have it listed in the description box down below, my new camera. People said that the batteries die quick, so tonight is really going to be the night that I test it, because I'm going out. So we'll see how this goes. I'm going to charge both of them up, and yeah, I'll let you guys know probably like tomorrow or later tonight how my batteries held up. But yeah, we'll see. I'll talk to y'all later. Hey you guys, so I'm on my way to the outing with my girls. That exam today, let me tell y'all, first of all, I couldn't find the exam, because you guys know we do the exam on lockdown browser. I couldn't find it. I think they posted it under a different section than they normally would. They posted it under assignments, when normally they post it under exams. So I spent 10 minutes trying to find it, and in those 10 minutes I was literally calling every professor's number that I could find. Even if you wasn't my professor, baby, I was calling you, because I'm gonna take this exam. Because if you miss the exam, then you have to do like an essay, and they say the essay is like horrible. I'm not doing no essay. Just give me the 50 questions, you know, like, I'm not doing that. So I literally called every single professor. No one answered. Absolutely no one answered my phone call. I'm of course like calling Kelsey, like the girls that I'm going out with now, but they're not answering because it's already 10 minutes into the exam. So they got their phones turned off, because again, we do our exams at home on lockdown browser. So you have to turn off like all your electronics. You can't have no phone calls, no nothing. So I didn't expect them to respond. I was hoping somebody respond, and one person did. One guy in like my other group chat, he responded, and he was the one that helped me like find it. But you guys know how it is when you have like a rough beginning, it just messes up your whole like feng shui, and that's exactly what it did. Like I said, I spent 10 minutes trying to find the exam. I'm like literally calling every single professor. Like, girl, I called the daggone professor that is in what is it called? Is it Loxahatchee? Is it Loxahatchee? I don't know. I called another professor that's like all the way, like not even, I don't care. I found the number, I called it. But yeah, I took the exam. I don't know how I feel just because of that, because I went into the exam like all frazzled, you know, but we'll see. Typically exam grades come out in 2 days. So I should have my exam grade by Thursday, and my birthday is Friday. So I'll feel better because like my anxiety will be down because I'll have my grade. I'll know what I have. But honestly, I'm not even sweating it. It's over. There's nothing else that I can do about it. Like, that's what I be trying to talk to y'all about too. Do not let a bad grade get you down. I'm not saying that I got one, but because I don't know yet. But there's nothing that I can do about it. You know, it's already done. I can't go back. So we'll see. I'll definitely update you guys on my exam grade. But y'all, I had a rough beginning of the exam because like I went in so like, I gotta take it, like, you know. And then y'all, hold on, one more thing. I was going to the restaurant. The restaurant that we're going to right now is Rocco's Tacos. And then pretty much we're gonna like bar hop pretty much. But I thought we were going to the one up north. So I'm super glad I checked the group chat before I left the house, because apparently there's one downtown, and the one downtown, of course, is closer to me versus getting on the highway and going up north. So I'm happy. But y'all, today is just a frazzled day for me. Like, but I am glad I checked the group chat, because your girl would have went to the one up north like, where y'all at? I got the table. Like, because I think it's like 6 or 8 of us. I'm not really sure how many people are coming, because I know there's some people coming outside of my like girlfriends. It's 5 of us, so I think there's like an extra 2 or 3 people. I actually asked Bae if he wanted to come. He couldn't make it. You guys know he had his exam today. He got an 85, so I'm like super happy for him. But after he has his exams, he has class. So I don't expect him to make it, because, you know, when he gets out of class, if I were to get out of class, I don't really, you know, I don't feel like going to, you know. So I was pretty sad, but it's okay. It would have been fun to have him. And, you know, he could have met everybody, because my boyfriend has never met like my nursing friends. He has only met Ederly and Francis, because those are like, you know, like my best friends, my home friends. So yeah, but I am 12 minutes down the street. Like I said, I'm really happy that we are going to the downtown one, because it's a straight shot for me. There's no highway or anything like that. But I'll talk to you guys once I get there. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to park in the garage, since it's like downtown, because I was so set on going to the one in Gardens. Like, I was. So yeah, I'll talk to you guys once I get there. I'll probably talk to you guys once I get to the table or something like that.
I don't need to think about it. There's nothing in this world that we can't do. Flowers even mad about it, cause they can't bloom like you don't. I don't see a way around it, cause everything has led me straight to you. It's nothing new. Baby, I'm outside, been thinking about you all night. Been thinking it ain't right if you and me only see us in our dreams. I'm outside, been thinking about you all night. Been thinking it ain't right if you and me only see
us. This is super cute.
So you guys, we actually made it to our second place.
Hi!
Rosie met us.
Hi! It's like, yeah, I have
energy. Y'all, it's like super good in here.
We which I just have to say, like, holy shit.
Cheers!
Waiting for June. I'm done and waiting for you. Waiting for you. Baby, I'm outside. Been thinking about you all night. Been thinking it ain't right if you.
Really? You said you don't? Good.
Who doesn't have a cupid
shuffle? Bro, this girl always wants to do the cupid shuffle.
I get options.
Hey, how are you? I can cupid shuffle, not here.
Shut up!
Do the right, do the right. Now I do, now I do. I need a beer and I need a cupid shuffle.
I can't.
Dreams, I'm outside. Been thinking about you all night. Been thinking it ain't right if you and me only see us in our dreams. I'm outside.
What is up, you guys? So it is actually the next day. It is Wednesday, September 22nd, and I actually just got home from clinical, so your girl is back in clinical. I'm actually really happy. Today was just orientation, but you guys know, being in the healthcare field, not just with school but with work also, it's very, you know, there's very little I can film, so that's why I don't even, like, I try to bring you guys in, but there's literally no way that I could talk to you guys unless, like, I'm in the bathroom. And what fun is that for you to see me talking to you in a bathroom, you know? Like, I can't whip out my camera. But, yeah, today was orientation. I got up this morning at 5:30. First of all, last night was lit. Y'all already seen that. Last night was lit. I got home. I didn't get home too late, actually. I got home probably at, like, I want to say 11:45. I was in the bed by, like, let's say 12:15, sleep the latest by 12:30. So I did get like a nice five and a half hour in of sleep. And then I got up this morning at 5:30 and I had to be at the hospital by 7. And like I said, today was just orientation. So we got acquainted with the hospital. Like, we, you know, met our professor for the first time. And, you know, we just got to see where we were going to be, and we got to learn about the hospital a little bit more, and that's it. I'm home, and it's 11:22. Like I said, I was there from 7 to 11. It was not long at all. So, I'm home today. I pretty much have the rest of the day to myself. I do have midterm evaluations with my online clinical professor, because now I have two. Well, I used to have two. I had a online, and then now I have like an actual in-person clinical professor. So I'm actually doing my evaluations with my online professor. She's just, you know, gonna talk to us. She said it may take like 10 minutes and then we're done. So I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna take the rest of the day to get some work done. I definitely want to edit the second part of my Q&A. I need to also handle my TB shot that's coming up, because with my job, we have to redo our TB shot every single year, and it's due the month of your birthday. So, of course, you guys know my birthday is Friday. So, I need to go ahead and get that scheduled so I can get that done. I also need to renew my my BLS, my basic life support, so my CPR card. I need to renew that. So it's required that I do my BLS certification at my job, I guess, because of course they want it to be like top tier. So I need to call them and schedule that after I'm finished the virtual portion, because there is two portions. There's virtual, and then there's like the actual hands-on, like actual chest compressions. I also have a couple of orders to pack now that I'm thinking about it. So like I said, I can definitely use this time today, and I'm going to use it wisely. By the way, this is my scrub cap from my brand DCD Galore. So if you haven't shopped, shop on my website. This is Flamazon Flamingos. These are little cute flamingos. I was debating between putting on the Tropical Breeze and Palm Trees ones. If you've been on my site, check my site out. You know exactly which ones I'm talking about. But Yeah, I have like the perfect caps to match your blue scrubs because like they're literally like navy and navy. As you guys can see, it's like the perfect navy. Yeah, I'm about to go ahead and head inside this house so I can get this work done. Today's really going to be a work day for me. I want to get a lot of stuff done today. So I may pick up the camera here and there, but I'm really not going to be doing anything. I do have a gym session tonight with my trainer at 6:45. So I'm probably not going to move my car until then, until I have to go to the gym tonight. So, yeah, but I may pick up the camera here and there to just talk to you guys really quick. But if not, I'll see you guys in the next clip, which may be, I don't know, at the gym or I don't know. I'll talk to y'all later.
I was thinking about way back when I thought I had it figured out, when I thought that I knew what to do and I didn't need you. I can't imagine if I stayed back, what would happen if I never found you. Those times were hard and all I did was resent you. Oh no, I don't want to go back. Oh, how naive I was. I'm running to where my hope is, where I know I'm free. Covenant with you. No longer will I look back to the sin I did. Surely your love and your goodness will forever be. Cause no, I don't want to go back. How naive I was.
Good morning, you guys. Welcome back to another day. I'm on my way to the gym right now. I did not pick up the camera yesterday because, y'all, I did not do anything. All I did was I was at the library literally all morning, of course, studying. I think I got to the library at like 9:30, 10 o'clock, and I did not leave until like around 4. And then when I came home from the library, I took like a miniature nap because I do have gym sessions on Thursdays at 6:45. So I went to the gym, and then of course when I got home from the gym at like 8:30, 8:45 p.m., I took a shower, and then your girl was out like a light, okay? So I did not pick up the camera yesterday, but I am going to pick it up today, although I'm pretty much doing the same thing, just in reverse. Instead of me going to the library this morning, I'm going to get the gym out the way. Now I'm going to come home, shower, and then I'm going to do some work. I did pick up a shift tonight, so we will be going to work tonight at 7. So, yeah, I did get the Velcro strips in the mail, y'all. I'm about to set it up right now because I'm tired of having nowhere to prop you guys. This is perfect when I'm sitting still, but when I start driving and hitting corners, my camera is sliding and gliding, okay? These are what the little Velcro strips look like. We're gonna see if they work. I'll link them down below because I always get questions from like other YouTubers here that watch my channel. And they always ask me, like, what do I use for my camera? What's good? So, if this is good, I'll link them down below so you guys can see what I got. So, here are the two sides. Of course, you have the, like, the stand-up side and then the side that sticks on. I've heard really good things about Velcro holding cameras in, like, people's cars, like, when they do car vlogs. So, I just ran inside to get my scissors because I am going to have to measure it to my camera and then just make sure, of course, it's not, like, going over the part where I'm supposed to get my battery out and my memory card. So, I'm going to go ahead and, like, measure it and then I'll come back and tell you guys. And we'll test it because I'm about to drive to the gym, so we'll see. I'll drive like normal, but I have a really good feeling. I have a feeling this is gonna work. The only thing that I'm really worried about is putting something right here on my dash, but I know because this is like a adhesive, but I usually use like Goo Gone. You guys know when you like park somewhere you're not supposed to park and they
they put like a sticker like dab in the middle of your window. There's a solution called Goo Gone. It's perfect for getting stickers and like decals and stuff. Like, let's say you had a decal from your old apartment that you put on your back window and you no longer live there, things like that. Like, it gets sticker residue off of your windows and stuff. So I'll link that down below as well. But let me go ahead and measure this onto my camera, because I do have to flip my camera upside down and stuff, and then I'll come back on here and we'll test it out, because I need to get to the gym so we can come home and do homework, relax before I gotta go to work, and yada yada yada. And I'm still debating if I want to pick up tomorrow, because I took off for 2 weeks. Y'all know my birthday was on Thursday the 24th. I took off for 2 weeks because I just wanted to chill. So I picked up tonight. I'll see how I'm feeling tomorrow. I'll see if, you know, my boyfriend or my friends are off. If they off, I'm probably gonna go out tomorrow night. I don't know, we'll see. Let me get this together. I'll be right back, y'all. This is clearly a fail. I am so sad. Like, it's not even just the sticky part. I'm sorry to be so up close and personal, but y'all, okay, I'm upset. I'm so disappointed. Ooh, and y'all all up in my face in this morning time. I'm not even like, bro, I feel like people would be mad. I mean, it was only $5. I'm upset because I was really hoping that this would work so I could like vlog in the car. I made it to the gym and epic fail. It's just not working. Like, I don't know what it is, and I cut it up, so of course I can't return it. I mean, it was only $5 anyways. Of course, the bottom half on my camera is perfect. It's really my dash that's the problem. It's not sticking to my dash. And I'm not gonna add any glue or do anything extra because I'm not trying to mess up my car, you know? So I'm about to have to keep looking and continue to search for a good camera holder for my camera, for the car. I don't know what to do. Oh, let's go in here and get this workout done. I also want to sit in the sauna. I haven't been in a sauna in probably like a good 2 weeks. Because usually when I leave the gym, I'm ready to go. I don't feel like, you know, sitting. So I'm only going to work out technically for an hour. So as soon as I walk in, I like to turn on the sauna so it's like already heating up. You know, that way when I'm finished, yeah, y'all, work smarter, not harder. Because it takes about 20 to 30 minutes for the sauna to get like super hot, like to its hottest. So I usually turn it on as soon as I'm walking in, and then it stays on for an hour. So literally in that hour I'm finishing up, the sauna is like still hot, and then I just crank it back up once I'm getting ready to hop in it. So let's go in here. I'm gonna take you guys inside the gym with me. Hopefully there's not a lot of people. I'm assuming there's not, because it's a Friday, 11 o'clock, everybody should be at work, I'm hoping. But I got my tripod. I'm gonna take you guys in here. Like I said, today is Friday. I don't have sessions on Friday, so I just really do my own thing. I planned on doing the workout from yesterday. I just try to do like a HIIT workout. I try to go super hard for like 30 minutes, like straight, less than 10 seconds off. Like after I do a rep, I give myself 10 seconds, and then because I'm trying to keep my heart rate up. That's the whole point of a HIIT, is to keep your heart rate up. I really do not like to let my heart rate fall below 160s when I'm working out, especially when I'm weightlifting. I need to keep my heart rate up. That's the whole point in HIIT. So I'm gonna do that for 30 minutes, and then I'm gonna do cardio for 30 minutes, and then we're gonna sit in the sauna for 20. So we should be out of here no later than 12. It's 10:48, about an hour, hour and 30, like I said, because I'm gonna give myself about a good 20 minutes in the sauna. So let's go in here and get it done, and yeah, enjoy my workout, because I get a lot of questions about what I do. So today is a self day. I'm doing what I wanna do, but I'm just doing the same workout from yesterday. I'm just gonna do it a lot quicker.
Hey, I'm just trying to keep up with the
Decided I was the blame. Got mad when we went our separate ways. Wreaked havoc. Your ego was way too hard. You look shattered. I almost cut my finger on your sharp edges. Forget the lies you told. I hope you feel better. I didn't leave because you stopped me. I just.
What is up, you guys? So, hold on. Let me pause this. I am about to start getting ready for work. I'm watching YouTube. I'm actually watching I Am Chelsea Jania. Y'all, she is hilarious. Like, I don't know how this is, like, my first time watching her channel, but she's hilarious. Hold on, let me show you guys. Here she is, but y'all, literally, this girl be cracking me up. She was crying off of a TikTok video. Like, girl, she had me dying, but that's what I'm watching right now. I'm about to go ahead and put all these clothes up, and then I'm gonna go ahead and start getting ready for work. It is 5:41, and you guys know that I said I picked up a shift tonight. By the way, I just have on my Skims. You guys have seen this before. I'll have it linked in the description box down below, but yeah, I'm about to get ready for work soon, and I'll talk to you guys later.
Hey, I'm just trying to keep up.
What is up, you guys? So it is actually Sunday, October the 3rd, and I'm gonna make this super quick because my camera is starting to overheat. I just pulled up to my nail appointment. I did not record this morning because I've been studying all morning, and I have a feeling, I just know you guys are tired of seeing me study and just seeing, you know, like fast clips of me writing, but literally that's all studying is. So I was like, you know what, I'm not even gonna pick up the camera. I'll pick up the camera when I go get my nails done. So yeah, I made a nail appointment early this morning, you guys. My nail tech actually just added the option to make same day appointments, so I'm super happy about that. Okay, but yeah, this is actually my best friend's Francis nail tech, but I've been coming to her for like the past 3 to 4 months, and she's really good. I'll have her you know, information down in the description box down below, but she actually just got a new suite, and I really love when nail techs and hairstylists get suites because it just shows you like their elevation. Also, of course, with safety, they're no longer doing hair and nails inside of their home. And I just, girl, I love the elevation. I love seeing other people, you know, elevate. But let me go ahead and get inside here because this is her walking up. So I'll see y'all later.
Hey guys, this is Haley.
Hello.
Like I said, you guys, I'll have all her stuff in the description box down below. Come on, yes, girl, show us your new suite.
Yes, this is me.
This is her. This is so pretty.
Thank you.
I love, like, this. I really like this.
I know.
It's super cute.
They got it from, like, IKEA or something like that.
Thank you. I was just telling him how he just, you moving on up on us.
Yes.
Although I've only been coming for, like, what, 3 months now?
Yeah.
3 months now?
But you've seen the progress.
I see the progress. And I was telling them, like, my best friend does hair, so it's really nice to see, like, because I know, you know, like, y'all do hair and nails out your house and stuff, so.
Exactly.
Especially, like, safety, too, because people come to y'all house and then they have your address.
Exactly.
And so it's really nice to see.
That's one of my reasons, my main reasons why.
To get one?
Sweet, yes.
All right, y'all.
No crazies at my house.
I told you about the way that I felt. Yeah. I wouldn't waste a minute if I had you all to myself. We'd be walking in the moonlight.
dating up to sunrise. Baby, you can let your walls come down. We'd be dancing in the corner, sleeping on my shoulder. You can come and have it all with me, if you want it, baby. If you got it bad like I got it bad for you. If you got it bad like I got it bad for you. Let me tell you about the way that I've been thinking about us.
Hey you guys, so I'm home. I decided to throw on my bathing suit and just sit out back and just relax. I got some wine, I got my speaker, and I'm gonna play some music and we just gonna vibe out, y'all. I'm gonna study later tonight. I wanna enjoy my Sunday. You guys know I'm usually not off on Sundays, so I really just want to enjoy my Sunday. So yeah, that's the plan for the rest of the day.
You wanted honesty, but couldn't find someone you could trust. So let me be your go-to. I could be the one who gives you everything you want and more.
What is up, you guys? So welcome back to the next day. I'm actually coming on here to shut out the vlog, but today is Monday, October the 4th. It's 1:07 and class is about to start at 1:30, so we need to make this super quick. But yeah, I woke up this morning to go and get my eyelashes done. Huge shout out to my eyelash tech, who is actually the owner of, you know, her business. She says that she watches me on YouTube. I thought that was pretty cool. Like, girl, I come to your eyelash studio to get my eyelashes done and you watch me on YouTube? Like, what? So yeah, I thought that was super cool. Huge shout out to her. I'll have her information listed in the description box down below, as well as my nail tech. I'll have all of them linked down below, but I just thought that was super cool. She said that she was scrolling on YouTube and then she saw one of my videos pop up and she was like, hey, I know her, that's Dominique. Like, I just thought that was funny. So yeah. But after I went to go and get my eyelashes done, I had to stop at Sephora to pick up one of the giveaway winners prize. She won a Chanel Gabrielle perfume, so I went to go and pick that up. And also I wanted to come on here and just show you guys what I picked up for my birthday. I took myself on like a mini shopping spree. I did not want to make a separate video for these items, so I was like, you know what, I'll just do like a haul in one of my vlogs. And I know a lot of you love to see like hauls, even if it is a luxury haul. And then a lot of you of course also love like my Fashion Nova hauls or my Zara hauls. So yeah, I don't feel like I need to do a disclaimer here on my channel because I've never had that problem. I know like a lot of YouTubers go through the whole like people think that they're bragging and stuff like that. Y'all always know I'm always here for spoiling yourself. And I personally love to do hauls on my channel because whenever I'm looking for something or I'm interested in a luxury product, I do a whole bunch of research. I don't just go out here and buy a $1,500 bag without doing research on it. It allows me to see what other people have to say about the product before I go out here and buy it and I don't like it. Of course you can do a return, but why not, you know, do your research and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start off with the stuff that I got from Sephora today. Like I said, I just went to grab her gift and then of course I picked up something for myself, duh. Okay, so from Sephora I got her gift. I got her the Chanel Gabrielle perfume. You guys know this is my holy grail. This was one of the prizes and like I said, I did have to go and pick that up. I did a pickup because I didn't want to do like shipping to the house and then it would take forever to come. I was like, you know what, I can just go and pick it up so I can get it shipped out ASAP. And while we're on the subject of giveaway prizes, you guys know that I had a 25k giveaway, so congratulations to all my winners who won. So like I said, one person won the Chanel Gabrielle perfume. I went to pick that up this morning. I also have three other winners who won the Golden Nurse Cold Pack. So two people won it black and one person won it white. So I have to go ahead and pack those up. I have to pack up everything, the perfume, the three cold packs, and then also I had another winner actually win a stethoscope. You guys know that was also another prize, was a classic 3 Lipman, any color of your choice, whichever color you want it, just let me know and I'll get it. So I'm not gonna open it, I just, you know, remove the packaging, but this is how I'm going to send it. She actually chose the pink one and I just wanted to make sure that the color was right and it is. And for those of you who actually want to see it, I'm not going to open it. I don't want to open up her stuff. I'll just show you guys mine. She got the same one that I got. And this is what it looks like. So this is mine, like I said, but she got the same one that I got, which is the pretty pearly pink, super cute. And then I just have like this little stamp on it that has my name. Not a stamp, but it's like a little nameplate, and it just says DCD. So yeah, those are all of the giveaway prizes. Well, those are all the physical ones that have to be packaged up. And I'm gonna go ahead and do those today so I can get them out. I already sent everyone their confirmation emails. Well, you know, like their congratulations emails. I already did all of the shipping labels. Sorry, you guys. My granddad came into town last night. You guys saw I got in the pool and stuff. And then my mom was like, hey, granddaddy will be here in an hour. So he's here. He spent the night last night. I guess he's going to be, you know, staying with us and just visiting us for a couple days or whatever. But yeah, if you guys hear anybody in the background, that's grandpa. So yeah, I need to go ahead and get out all of these prizes. So the code pack, the perfume, and the stethoscope. Like I was saying, I already sent out all the congratulation emails. And in those emails, I had already sent them their tracking number, so now I just have to get everything out. That is the beauty of having my own business. Your girl does not have to deal with the post office. I literally package everything by myself. I get shipping labels done, like, girl, tracking numbers, everything I can do at home. Okay, continuing on with Sephora. When I went to Sephora to pick up her gift, I went ahead and got one of my holy grails. So this is the Dr. Dennis Gross Extra Strength Daily Peel. I absolutely love this. I'm going to be doing a skincare routine for you guys, an updated skincare routine for you guys, and this is definitely going to be in there. I love to use this whenever my skin feels like super textured. I actually used this last night, and I used my last one. So I went ahead and picked up a new box, but absolutely love this. I love to use it, like I said, whenever my skin feels like super textured, it feels uneven. I love to go ahead and do one of those, and it usually gets your girl together. So another Sephora bag, like I said, I got that today. So when I was actually shopping for my birthday, I went ahead and picked up my birthday gift. You guys know, if you're a member of Sephora, whenever your birthday rolls around, you can pick up a birthday gift. And I love to always like get miniature things because I like to try out new things instead of, you know, getting a big one. I don't like it and then I'm mad because I spent my money on a big one. So I love to get new things in the mini set, that way I can try it out. And you guys will see that again right now. So I got a mini OE oil, I think that's how you pronounce it. I've actually heard very good things about this and I've been using it. I don't know if you guys can tell, but a little bit is gone. I've been using it and I actually really, really love it. I love the smell. It actually caught me by surprise how good it smells. At first I was like, hold on, is that my perfume smelling like that? No, it's the hair oil. It smells really good. A lot goes a long way, so you only need a little bit, just a small pump, rub it in the palm of your hands, and then you can go ahead and moisturize your hair. So that's what I mean. I love to get miniature, you know, items, that way I can try them out, see how I like it. But I'm definitely going to be purchasing a bigger bottle of that because I really like it and I heard really good things about it. So I just wanted to go ahead and try it for myself. Moving on, I went ahead and picked up my holy grail hair oil. You guys know that I absolutely love the Moroccan oil hair oil. And this is, of course, located at Sephora. So I like to get it in light, that way my hair doesn't feel weighed down. I really, really love this. And I got a miniature of this one because I knew I was getting another hair oil and I didn't want to get a big one of this, actually like this, and I'd be like, dang, I got a lot of hair oil in my house now, you know. So I'm actually really glad that I got a miniature of my holy grail and then I got a miniature of this one because I actually like it and I'm using it. So yeah, while we're on the whole subject of hair care, I went ahead and picked up another one of my holy grails. This is the Moroccan oil intense hydrating mask. I'm pretty much just re-upping on all of my stuff. Like I said, I love this, I love this too. So I went ahead and picked up another one. This smells super good, and y'all, when I tell y'all, this is that girl, okay? This is that girl. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all,
this stuff can be pricey. I think this is $38, but when I tell you, it is so worth it. It is so worth getting like the Moroccan oil hairline, and I will actually be doing an updated hair care routine also. So that's low-key why I'm re-upping on all my stuff, not only because I'm running out, but you guys know that my bathroom is finished. The whole reason why I wasn't doing my updated skincare routine and my updated hair routine was because my bathroom was being renovated, but it's finished. So it's about that time, girl. And like I said, I just need to re-up on all my stuff. And last but not least, I went ahead and picked up a new Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. And I actually got this one in the color Honey. You guys know that Laura Mercier dropped some new shades. I think it was earlier this year. I could be totally wrong, but I know they dropped recently some new shades and they came out with the color Honey. And when I tell you guys, this is amazing for our skin tones being melanin. We do not get that, you know, flashback whenever you take photos. Y'all know I love me some Laura Mercier, and this is the one in translucent, and I still have some in here because when I discovered this, when I actually tried this, when they dropped it, I absolutely fell in love. So I do keep this for backup because I'll still use it if I run out of this one and, you know, like I'm running out the house and I didn't realize I didn't have any setting powder. I'll use, you know, I'll go back to my translucent, but absolutely love this. If you are melanin like myself, girl, definitely try the color Honey with the Laura Mercier translucent powder because you do not get that flashback in y'all. Okay, just know. So that's everything that I got from Sephora. While we're on the whole makeup trend, let's go ahead and open up this PR package that I got from e.l.f. So e.l.f. does send me all of their new products. I think that's pretty freaking cool. Like, I'm on their PR list. Like, who am I? But anything that e.l.f. drops, they send me, and I absolutely love it because, again, I love trying new products because once I like it, I'm going to go get the bigger version. And I see that this is e.l.f. skin, so I'm actually really excited to try this because, of course, whenever I get something from e.l.f., it's always like makeup, it's primer, it's like, you know, eyeshadow and stuff like that. So let me go ahead and get my little cutter so we can open this together because I got that yesterday and I didn't open it. So let's go ahead and open this up. When I tell y'all, e.l.f.'s like packaging is always on point. It is always on point. And by the way, this video is not sponsored by them. Like I said, they sent this yesterday and I was like, you know what, let's just go ahead and open it on camera. And like I said, presentation is always on point. So they went ahead and sent over a sleeping mask, a hydrogel moisturizer, a face cream, another sleeping mask, but this one says hemp cannabis sativa, and a facial oil, and girl, a jade roller. I'm really excited to try this. I'm not gonna take everything out of the box because I do wanna go ahead and get my Instagram story. Y'all know how that go, but thank you to e.l.f. for sending this over. I'm actually really excited to try this. Again, y'all, I love trying new products because once I like it, I'm gonna go buy the big version. Okay, continuing on with what I purchased myself for my birthday. So I did stop at Tory Burch and I picked up two pairs of sandals. You guys know Tory Burch is infamous for their famous like Miller sandals, so that's what I picked up. I picked up two pairs, and I'll have everything that I'm mentioning down in my description box down below. So like I said, I went ahead and picked up two pairs. Let me tell you guys the colors before I show them. So I got a black pair and it's called Perfect Black, and then I got this other color called Light Makeup. I went in to get the tan one, but when I saw this one, it was a little bit more lighter than tan. Sorry, you guys, my phone is blowing up. Yeah, I saw this one and I really liked it more than their actual tan one. So I'll show you guys this one first because it's just sitting on top, you know? So these are the sandals. This is, like I said, the light makeup color. And as you guys can tell, it's a little bit lighter than your normal like top or tan. So that's why I really, really like this color. And the next pair, like I said, is in the color black. And for both of my sandals, I did not get them in glossy. I got them in the matte. I don't know. I just feel like, I don't know, I just did not like the glossy, so I just got them both in the matte. And like I said, I absolutely love the Tory Burch Miller sandals. They're something you can just throw on when you're running out the house. You could even wear these out like a night that you're going out. You don't want to wear heels, girl, put on your Tory Burches and call it a night, okay? And you'll still look super cute. So I picked up these two, y'all. I actually noticed for my birthday, I got all shoes. I did not notice that until, like, I was going through my bags and I was like, wait a minute, like, I got all shoes except for the Sephora stuff. You guys will see, like, all I bought for my birthday were shoes. I don't know if subconsciously I'm telling myself that I need more shoes, but your girl literally bought all shoes for her birthday. I don't know what's up with me. That's the Tory Burch bag. My mouth is dry. Moving on, I went to Saks Fifth. So there's actually a story behind this. I never knew Saks Fifth ever existed because whenever I was in the market, you know, like for a luxury item, I would just go on the luxury items website. So let's say I'm looking for like a Louis bag, I'm just gonna go on LouisVuitton.com, or if I'm looking for like something Dior, I'm just gonna go on Dior. So I found out that Saks Fifth existed through my old English teacher's YouTube. So shout out to Miss Darling. I'll have her YouTube listed in the description box also. But I was watching one of her vlogs and she went to Saks and I was like, where is this place? I need to find this place. I need to go to this place. So I went to Saks and y'all, I fell in love. I was like, I don't know how, I've never heard of this place ever. I've never been there. So again, huge shout out to Miss Darling because I did not know Saks existed before I even, you know, watched her YouTube. And y'all know when you're in high school, you're not allowed to follow, you know, like your teachers and stuff on social media. But as soon as you graduate, it's different. So that is my girl. Like Miss Darling, me and her, we are like this. That's my girl. We actually got to go get lunch one day because that's my boo. But y'all go ahead and check out her YouTube. I'll have it listed in the description box down below. She does fashion, luxury hauls, everything like that. She's super cool. So that's how I came about Saks Fifth, because like I said, I didn't even know it existed. Like, bro, there is a department store with a whole bunch of luxury stuff in it and I did not know about it. Like, now I don't have to go on individual websites or go to individual stores. I can just go to the department store and just look around. Okay, I went ahead and purchased some Alexander McQueen oversized sneakers. These are actually very, very popular and I wanted to get these just in time for fall because I feel like this is such a fall shoe, you guys. Like, the look I have in my head is so classic with this shoe. And again, you guys have probably seen these, they're literally everywhere, and I got them in the most basic color ever. I got them in black and white. Pretty much the base is white and then the black you know, backing or whatever. You guys don't see what I'm talking about. I don't know why I can't think right now, but these are what they look like. Super plain, but y'all, I don't know, I just really wanted these. I feel like these are gonna be super cute with like some leather leggings, a really nice, you know, plain white shirt, and then you can even throw on like a nice leather jacket or like a trench coat, something like that. They're just the plain oversized sneaker, and you guys might be looking at these like, girl, you are crazy, like you could have got these at Forever 21, but I don't know, I just really wanted these. They're super cute and I finally got them. So yeah, I got these in a size, what size did I get these in? I got these in a size 40. So yeah, in case you are interested, I do wear a size about, I want to say 8.5, 9. If you are able to go in the store and try them on, of course, go ahead and do that. But for size reference, I did get a size 40 and I wear like a size 8.5, 9. So yeah, I'm super excited to wear these. Like I said, I have an idea in my head how I want to style these for the fall time. And that time is definitely here, you guys. It's already October. So yeah, I went ahead and picked those up. And then next I went to Gucci. So I did not only buy shoes, I did buy one product that was not a shoe. So like I said, I did stop by Gucci and I just picked up another fall item, you guys. I really waited to get some of these items for fall because I feel like this is definitely a fall item and this is definitely another statement piece. And this is my first time ever going to Gucci, so I'm actually really excited to finally have their packaging in my closet. I definitely think that this green is super cute because I think Gucci used to have like black and white, right? But yeah, I went ahead and picked up a Gucci belt. So just a plain, you know, staple piece that you can wear all year round, especially in the fall. I went ahead and picked up the medium size Gucci belt because I know they have a super small one, they have a medium one, and then they have like the humongous G. I did not want the small one because I felt like it was too small compared to like my body proportion. I feel like the super small one would be good for someone who's like really petite. Don't get me wrong, I'm small, I'm 5'2", but I'm not that small. So I was like, you know what, I think the medium size one would be nice. And I did not want the big one because the big one is like in your face. I don't want that. I want something that's, you know, it's not flashy, but then at the same time, compared to my body size, it's not like super, super small, you know? So this is what it looks like. I did get the dull color because you guys know that Gucci does have a shiny belt. I did not want the shiny one. I just want something super chill. And like I said, I can definitely see me wearing this with like all black. This would be super cute with some black heels if, you know, you're going out nighttime. You guys, I always have looks in my head, and this was definitely a staple piece that I wanted to go ahead and grab. So super happy that I finally got it. And like I said, this was my first time ever being in Gucci. I definitely want to go back because I saw like some Gucci shoes that were like super cute. You guys, their Gucci loafers are to die for. Like, I saw those in the store too, and I was like, no girl, we are coming in here for one thing because you are hitting these other stores, ma'am. You're not about to go in here and go crazy. I can't remember which size belt I got, but for size reference, I do wear like a size 7-8 in jeans. That's the dryer going off, but I do wear like a size 7-8 in jeans. So when I find the belt size, I'll have it listed down below also. And the way that I got it measured for when I wear high-waisted things, because you guys know your waist and your actual like hip size is different. Your waist is going to be smaller if you have, you know, like that curviness. So up here I wear a size 7/size 8, and then of course my hips are a little wider. So yeah, I'll have my measurements down below in the description box in case you are interested in getting a Gucci belt and we're around the same size. I'll also have, you know, like my other measurements that I can think of that may help. But again, you guys, if you can go in the store to try this stuff on, definitely go in because you never know. You never know. Although I may wear like a size 7-8, our body types just may be different. So if you can go in, definitely go ahead and try on these pieces so you can see how they, you know, look and fit on you. So this next piece kind of just came in also. I had to order these in the store because they did not have my size. And they are another pair of sneakers. And I don't know, this purchase kind of threw myself off when I bought it. I was like, are you sure you want these? Are you sure? And this is actually from a new spot in the mall because I went to Gardens Mall. This is actually a new shoe store in the mall called, I think it's called Impossible Kicks. So pretty much they have pieces that are hard to find. And if I'm not mistaken, all the pieces are like higher than what they would normally be because you can no longer find them. Like for instance, Yeezys, which are like $80 when they first came out, inside of Impossible Kicks, girl, they're $400. For those Yeezy foam runners, I think they were like $390, $400. No ma'am, no ma'am. So I went ahead and picked up these Air Jordan 1 Lows, and I got them in the yellow ones. They're called white/pollen because you guys know pollen is yellow. I see what they did there. That's actually really cute. So this is my first time seeing them since I ordered them, because y'all see I literally just unboxed them, but I think they're super cute. They're white and they're the low top, so I just have to go ahead and find like some cute t-shirts to wear with these. I definitely see myself wearing these with like sweatpants, and like I said, getting like some really cute graphic t-shirts. This would be super cute. So yeah, I need to go ahead and try these on to make sure that they fit, because if they don't, I need to go ahead and go to the store. I need to go back to the mall where I just came from this morning to get a new size. But I'll try these on off camera to see if they fit. So that's another shoe that I ordered. And you guys, my last item that I got for my birthday are actually not from
the mall. I have a personal shopper. I actually have two personal shoppers. I'll list them both down in my description box below. I love to have personal shoppers because, of course, if I cannot find something on my own, if I'm going to the store, I'm going to Saks now that I know Saks exists, boo. If I can't find it, my next resort is to go to my personal shopper. So these shoes are really hard to find, and it's because everyone, of course, wants them in the color black. It's easier for me to find them in the yellows and in the nudes. I can even order it off of Tom Ford, but the black ones literally fly off the shelves. It's honestly annoying because I've been looking for them, and I was like, you know what, it's time to go to my girl. So I'll have her information down below. So yes, I do use a personal shopper, and I actually got a lot of questions about my Chanel earrings, like where I got my Chanel earrings from, because they are super hard to find. I use my personal shopper, so I'll have both of them listed down below in case you guys are looking for an item and you can't find it and you really want it. Definitely hit them up and, you know, see if they can find it for you. So my girl was able to find my black Tom Ford padlock heels, you guys. I'm so happy. And you guys may look at these heels like, girl, these heels are so plain. But I told y'all, I'm getting to that point where I need like staple pieces in my closet. I've had, you know, just regular black sandal heels from Forever 21. But I, again, am getting to that point where I just want to have staple pieces. And those staple pieces, of course, are going to be a little bit more expensive. So I went ahead and picked up these Tom Ford padlock heels in the color black, and this is just your typical sandal heel. I think these are absolutely perfect. They're super cute. So I actually unboxed them last night, and I'm actually about to return them because they don't fit. These shoes run super small, and she was telling me that, so we were like, okay, should I get a 39, should I get a 40? And I texted her this morning because I tried them on last night, and I told her that they didn't fit, but she told me that they have another size. So I'm gonna go ahead and return these. But before I return them, I just wanted to show you guys because she has a 41 and a half that she's gonna send me once, you know, she receives this one. But I was like, you know what, I'll just go ahead and unbox them for you guys so you guys can see them, because I'm just gonna, you know, exchange them to get another size. But you guys, they run super small. So again, if you can go in the store to try them on, go in the store to try them on. I wish I was able to, but literally no one has them. No one. And I wasn't about to drive all the way to Miami to try on some shoes. I was like, you know what, I'll just go ahead and order one size, hope they fit. If not, we'll just, you know, we'll keep doing it. And you guys know with heels, they need to fit. They can't be too big because then you're going to be wobbling. You need your heels to fit perfect. And of course, they can't be too small because your heel is going to be off the back, especially if it's a sandal heel. But yeah, let me stop rambling and unbox these shoes so you guys can see. But this is what they look like. You guys, these heels are so pretty, and I can't wait until I get mine. Like the ones that are actually gonna fit me. These fit, don't get me wrong. I just feel like I could definitely use a bigger size. So this is what they look like. Again, they're just a classic heel, but they are Tom Ford. And you guys see that they have the little padlock right here. Super beautiful, you guys. Like, this is such a, like, y'all already know what I mean when I do this. It's just like a yes ma'am heel. Like, these are so cute, and I feel like you can, of course, pair these with anything. They're just your typical sandal heel. You can wear these with jeans, you can wear this with a dress, skirt, anything that you need to wear them with. And they do have other colors in case you don't want black, but you guys know I reach for black and white first. That is just me. I want basic colors in my wardrobe. So I did get the black ones, although I was eyeing the new ones. I think I'll go ahead and like break these in. Well, break the new ones in, then I'm gonna get the other size. I'll see how I like them. If I really like them, I think I'll go ahead and get the new ones because the new ones are cute too. You always need a classic black sandal heel in your closet, and you also need a nude one. And I think they also have a white, you guys. They have a ton of colors. They have yellow, they have silver. But like I said, whenever I start off with stuff like Louis bags, I'm gonna get basic ones. Like my first Chanel bag, I want to be black, or I want it to be white. I'm not gonna start off with a pink Chanel bag. No ma'am, we're gonna start off with some basic colors. So yeah, I cannot wait until I get my other size in the mail. She said that she's gonna go ahead and send me a return label so I can go ahead and get this out to her. If I can get this out today, that'll be perfect. When I go ahead and drop off the winner's giveaway stuff, I'm going to go ahead and pack that up. And then if I can get this out today, I'll be happy, because as soon as she gets this, the sooner she can send out my other one. And then your girl can have her heels, because I want to wear them. Okay. But yeah, you guys, that is literally everything that I purchased for my birthday. I love all my little purchases. I can't wait to wear them. Like I said, I need to find some graphic tees to go with the dunks, the pollens. They're super cute. But yeah, I just thought I'd show you guys what I picked up for my birthday. I treated myself for my birthday. And yeah, cheers to 22, sis. Okay. But I'm gonna go ahead and end the vlog here, because class is actually about to start. Oh yeah, you guys, I almost forgot, but for my birthday I also got a new TV. I went ahead and purchased a bigger and like a smart TV, because my old TV was not a smart TV, so which meant I couldn't watch Netflix on it, I couldn't watch like Hulu and stuff like that. And I did have a Fire Stick, but although it was like a flat screen TV, I think you guys have seen my TV before, it was a flat screen, but it wasn't a smart TV. So even when I put my Fire Stick back there, it was like all pixelated. Your girl needed a new TV, and I'm really trying to work on making my room comfortable, because when I come home from school and work, I just really want to relax. So I was like, you know what, let's go ahead and buy a new TV. So I bought I think it's a 65 inch Samsung, and then like I said, it is a smart TV, so now I can watch YouTube, I can watch Hulu and stuff from my TV. And then also, you guys, I put like some really cute lights behind there. I'll have, again, everything listed down below in my description box. And y'all, I burnt myself, but yes, I put some like really cute lights behind them to set the mood. You know, whenever you're watching something, you can have like the purple lights or the pink lights or the blue lights. I love it at night, because like I turn those lights on and then I have like a candle burning, it'd be a vibe in my room. Okay, but yeah, I'll have all that listed in the description box down below. And I got the TV from Best Buy, and I got the lights from Amazon. Of course, Best Buy and Amazon, my go-to places. Best Buy is my go-to place for electronics, period. Cameras, everything like that is gonna come from Best Buy when it comes to me. But yeah, you guys, that is all for my haul. I hope you guys enjoyed. I love to show things that I purchased, because you guys may be interested, or y'all may be in the market for some of this stuff. And yeah, that is gonna go ahead and wrap up this vlog. I have no idea how this vlog is about to turn out. I have a feeling that this vlog is about to be like everywhere. I have no idea. So we'll see when I put the footage together and I start to edit. But I'll talk to you guys in the next one. I hope you guys enjoyed. I actually tweeted and asked if I should do Vlogmas, and literally all of y'all said yeah. So I am probably going to be doing Vlogmas this year. Vlogmas is when you pretty much upload vlogs every day in the month of December up until Christmas. So that'll be exciting. I'm gonna decide if I want to do it. If so, y'all know I gotta plan everything out in my life, so I would have to plan like every video that y'all would get each day, so I can stay on track, so you guys would get a video each and every day. But we'll talk more about that, you know, later. I'll see you guys in the next one. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.